Welcome to Vinix Studio. Let's start making games.
Hi and welcome. In the last two videos on visual scripting, we saw how to get started with Unity's visual scripting and how to add blocks and how to connect them around in your visual script. From this video onwards, we'll be creating a complete game and we'll not be doing it as a single video. We'll be doing it as a series of videos. So for the first video, we'll be setting up the basic requirements and making the player move. So the whole idea of the game is basically an endless runner. So the player will be moving in the Z direction. And when the left or the right arrow is pressed, the player will move to the left and right. That is to basically avoid the obstacles. So to get started, let's first add a 3D plane to our scene. And let's reset the transform. And we'll scale the plane in the Z direction by 10. And then we'll also add a 3D capsule, which will be our player. So let's reset the transform and set the Y to 1. And let's move it in the negative Z so that it's near the camera. Now to differentiate the plane and the capsule, let's add some different color to the plane. So if you have never created a material in Unity, you can just right click on the project window, go to create and select create material. So once you create a material, it will have a material like this. You can go to the albedo of the material and change the color to your requirement. So I already have a black material, so I'll just drag and drop that onto my plane. You cannot drag and drop it in the game window. You have to do it in the scene window. Now, since in our game, we'll need to detect collisions, and collisions will not work without a rigid body. So it is better to use physics even to move the game object. So let's select capsule, and in order to use physics, you have to add a component called rigid body. So let's add rigid body. Now everything is set. The next step that we have to do is just create a visual script. So to create the visual script, just click on add component and search for script. You should see a component called script machine. And when you add script machine, another component called variables will be added. So if you want to have any public variables that are accessible from other game objects, and you want to change the value in the editor, then you can add a variable here. So we need to control the speed of this game object. So let's set the variable name to speed and click on the plus sign. So you can see that the type is null. I'll set it to float and I'll set the initial value to 1. Now we'll have to create a new graph. So let's click on new and let's call it player moment. So now I have a graph called player movement. So let's click on edit graph. So as we saw in our introductory video on visual scripting, that whenever you create a new visual script, the start and the update event will be added to it. And in this case, we don't require both of them because they're not going to initialize anything. And we don't require the update because we will be doing physics calculations, and it's better to do the physics calculation inside the fixed update. So we need to add a note called fixed update on fixed update. We also need the variable that we created outside. It's called speed. So we'll just drag and drop it from here. So in the blackboard, it's available under the object tab. So now we need to move the player in the Z direction. So we need to just set the velocity of the rigid body in the Z direction. So the note that we required is set velocity. Okay, so now you can set the value of velocity from here. You can just enter a value and it will set the velocity, but we don't want that. We need to have some control. So we need to set the speed to the velocity of the rigid body, but the velocity node takes in a vector 3 value, whereas our speed is a float value. So what we have to do is we have to introduce another node, which is vector 3. So once you go inside vector 3, there will be a lot of options. So we need to select vector 3, x, y, and z. Okay. Now just assign this variable to the z value of the vector 3 and then set a vector 3 value to a set velocity. Also remember, you need to collect the flow of the graph, which is from fixed update. We'll call the vector 3. And once the vector 3 is created, we'll set it to the velocity of the rigid body. Now that it's done, you can just go back to Unity and test if it's working. So as you can see, the player is trying to move forward, but it is falling down. That is because the velocity is trying to push it forward, and because of the friction, it is falling down. But we don't want this behavior, so you can just select the capsule, go to the rigid body, and under constraints, you will see an option freeze rotation. Make sure you check X, Y, and Z, because we are not going to rotate the game object in any case. If we go ahead and play the game, so the player is moving forward and it's not falling down now. Now the next thing that we need is whenever the right or the left arrow is pressed, the player should move to the right and the left direction. Now to do that, let's go back to the visual script. So we need to set the X velocity based on the player input. So let's just remove this and let's go and search for input. So inside input, you should search for get access. So you have a node called get access. And you have to type in the access name as horizontal. Make sure you type in correctly. If the spelling or the capitalization is wrong, it will not work. So you get the input.get access. So you get the horizontal access input. And then you assign, and then you create a vector 3 and set the value to the velocity. Now, whatever value you're getting from the horizontal, you need to multiply that with the speed and set it to the x-axis. So let's just create another node called multiply. And then multiply the speed and the output of the get axis. And then connect that to the x-axis of the vector 3. So now the vector 3 has both x velocity and the z velocity. When the player is not pressing any key, the value coming out of the get axis is 0. So basically your x velocity is 0. And whenever the player presses the left arrow, the get axis gives a value between 0 and minus 1. And when the player presses the right arrow, the get axis gives a value between 0 and 1. So now our visual graph is ready. Let's just go and increase the speed because it was very slow and set it to 3. And let's play the game. So the player is moving forward and I'm also able to move in the left and right direction. So that's it for the player movement. In the next video, we'll try to make the camera follow the player. Stay tuned and see you in the next tutorial.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.